హలో అండ్ వెల్కమ్ టు స్టడీ టైం. అబ్రాడ్ లో చదువుకోవాలి, అబ్రాడ్ లో సెటిల్ అవ్వాలి, ఇదే ఇప్పుడు చాలా మంది యూత్ కళ అని చెప్పొచ్చు. అబ్రాడ్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అనగానే ఫస్ట్ గుర్తొచ్చేది యుఎస్. యుఎస్ లో సెటిల్ అవ్వాలనుకుంటారు. సో యుఎస్ లోని కాంకర్డియా యూనివర్సిటీలో ఎడ్యుకేషన్ పర్సూ చేస్తే ఎలా ఉంటుంది, ఈ యూనివర్సిటీ ఏమేమి ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ ని ఆఫర్ చేస్తుంది, వన్స్ కోర్సెస్ ఫినిష్ అయ్యాక కెరీర్ ఆపర్చునిటీస్ ఏ విధంగా ఉంటాయి, ఇలాంటి విషయాలపై అవగాహన కల్పించడానికి యూనివర్సిటీ నుంచి డైరెక్టర్ ఆఫ్ ఇంటర్నేషనల్ స్టూడెంట్ సర్వీస్ టిఫానీ లోబ్ మనతో పాటు ఉన్నారు. వారితో మాట్లాడదాం. హలో టిఫానీ.
Hi,
welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
So yes, first of all, we'll talk about the Concordia University. What are all the specialties of this Concordia University and why should student choose this university? What do you say on this?
Sure. Yeah. So at Concordia University St. Paul, students can study undergraduate, graduate, and doctorate programs. Okay. And so especially at the undergraduate level, we have over 70 majors that students can choose from. Some of the most popular ones are business, international business, graphic design, community health science, and we even have an esports team that students can join and participate on and receive scholarships for. On the graduate side, we have programs in information technology management, data analytics, and MBA. And so those programs are really good for students who are looking to take the next step in their education and their career.
Okay, so what are any entrance tests required to get eligibility for these programs?
Sure. So at Concordia University St. Paul, you don't need to take any tests like SATs or ACTs to join. We just require an application, an English proficiency score, which could be IELTS or TOEFL or Duolingo, a statement of why you want to study at Concordia, and also a bank statement to show the cost of attendance of studying there.
Okay, so what is the admission process exactly, the admission process to get into the university?
Sure, absolutely. So at Concordia, there is no application fee that is waived. So students can just reach out to the phone number on the screen or the email ID on the screen to start the application process. So students are able to do a free application to Concordia where they'll turn in their personal details through the application and then also their language test score, which for the undergraduate side should be equal to 5.5 on IELTS, and on the graduate side should be equal to 6.0 on IELTS. And students, we're also looking for, on the undergraduate side, at least a 3.0 on a 4-point scale. And on the graduate side, we're looking for first class or first division and also 6.0 on a 10-point scale.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So what are the program start dates and do we have any deadlines to apply and what is the right time to apply?
Sure. Yeah. That's a great question. So for undergraduate programs, students can start studying in the fall semester, which starts in September, or students can start studying in the spring semester, which starts in January. And on the master's side, students can start studying in the fall semester, which begins in September, the spring semester in January, or the summer semester, which begins in May. And the application deadlines for each of those semesters is 2 months before the semester starts. But we always tell students that applications are already open for the next term, and so they should just apply early so that they can get their acceptance letter, be able to get their I-20 and their visa appointment without having to feel rushed.
Okay, so what will be the cost of study for both the undergraduate and the graduate programs?
Sure. So on the undergraduate side, we ask that students show $40,500 USD, and that cost includes tuition, fees, living expenses, and also miscellaneous costs like books and health insurance for 2 semesters of study. On the graduate side, we ask that students show $35,000 USD for studying, and that includes the cost of tuition, fees, living expenses, books, health insurance, but that's actually for 3 semesters on the graduate side.
Okay, so do you offer any scholarships?
We do. On the undergraduate side, we offer many scholarships. And so, for example, students can get merit-based scholarships on the undergraduate side, and those are awarded to any students who have high school GPAs of 3.0 or above. And students are automatically awarded their scholarships in the admission process. So there's no extra steps that students need to take in order to be awarded a scholarship when they apply to Concordia. They just complete their application and they'll find out automatically if they are awarded any scholarships. In addition to that, we have scholarships for talent. So if students are joining our music program or our theater program, they're eligible for certain scholarships, as well as if students are athletes and joining our school's Division II athletics, they can be eligible for scholarships as well. For example, right now we have a lot of international students who are on our swimming team or other athletic teams, and they're all receiving scholarships. And one of our athletics that also awards scholarships is our esports team. So for students that are interested in esports, there's some opportunity to join the university's team for that and be awarded scholarships as well. So there are many good scholarship opportunities on the undergraduate side.
Okay, that's great. And do you offer any on-campus accommodation for the students who are coming from India?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sure. So on campus, we do have several residence halls where students can live. So we have residence halls for first year students, for men and women. And we also have residence halls for upperclassmen that are more apartment style. So students would have four roommates and share an apartment with a kitchen and a living room. And both undergraduate and graduate students are eligible to live in that housing, which we call upperclassmen housing. So all students can be eligible. The cost of living expenses at Concordia is about $10,000 USD per year. And the on-campus residence halls are really popular because they're so close to all of the classroom buildings. So it's really convenient for students to live there. And so we just let students know that they'll want to apply really early if they're interested in living in the residence halls on campus.
Okay, so is this sufficient for the students, or students need to go for the part-time jobs?
So there are some part-time jobs available when students are studying with us. So we have on-campus jobs, and the nice thing about on-campus jobs is that students can do those from any time while they're studying with us. They could do those from their first semester if they want to. So there's no need to wait with an on-campus job until students have been on campus for several semesters or even several years. So when an office on campus has a job opening available for students, they post it to our university's job board. And so all students are able to look there to see what's available, and they can apply directly on that website for that job. And another resource that we have available on campus to help students find employment is our Office of Career Development. And that office can help students with their US style resume, US style cover letter. They can also help students with searching for an on-campus job and just really kind of guiding students through that process. As well as when students get to the point in their studies where they're ready for an off-campus internship or job opportunity, the Office of Career Development can help support students in the next step too.
Okay, we have a caller.
Sure.
To talk to you. Hello, Naikar.
Hello, madam. Excuse me, madam. Hello.
Yes, yes. Maatladandi, Tiffany garu.
Okasari connect cheyandi, madam. Hello.
Yes, yes. She is listening. Cheppandi.
Madam, my children is study BSc Computer Science, madam. Distance mode. Hello.
Computer Science.
BSc Computer Science history.
Yeah, yeah. BSc. He was studying BSc Computer Science. Latestly, he was completed, madam.
Okay. మేక్ ఇట్ క్లియర్ అండి, ఎప్పుడు కంప్లీట్ చేశారు?
ఈ దిస్ ఇయర్ మేడం, 2022.
ఓకే, ఫైన్.
హి వాస్ గోయింగ్ టు వెంట్ టు ద యుఎస్ఏ, ఎనీ ఛాన్స్ ఇస్ దేర్?
ఓకే, సో హిస్ సన్ కంప్లీటెడ్ బిఎస్సి కంప్యూటర్ సైన్స్ ఇన్ 2022, దిస్ ఇయర్ ఓన్లీ. అండ్ ఈస్ హీ ఈస్ ఆస్కింగ్ దట్ ఇస్ దేర్ ఎనీ ఛాన్సెస్ ఫర్ హిస్ సన్ టు గో టు యుఎస్ టు పర్స్యూ ఎనీ ఫర్దర్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్?
షూర్. సో probably a good fit for a student who has done their bachelor's in computer science would be either our information technology management program or our data analytics program. With information technology management, those classes really focus on students that are interested in being a team leader or a project leader within IT. So those classes really focus on IT, but also the leadership skills. So students will really learn more about themselves and their leadership style. For example, they'll take the Clifton Strengths Finder, and their professors will work with them to understand the strengths they bring to their work environment, but also how they can work more collaboratively with others. And another program that could be a good fit for someone with a computer science background would be the Master's in Data Analytics, which we will have open for the January intake as well. And so the Data Analytics program is really nice for students with an IT background who enjoy the technical side. So that's where students could get jobs in analyst roles for companies, for example.
Okay, so yes, Naik Garu, BSc Computers background kabatti IT course teeskochani cheptunnaru, and another choice vachesi Masters in Data Analytics. Ee rendu programs ki vellochani suggest chesaru. Yes, Stephanie, what is the importance of doing Data Analytics program in Concordia University? What are the advantages?
Sure. So Data Analytics will prepare students who are interested in the more technical pieces of IT. And so right now in the US, there are a lot of people looking for people with a data analytics background. So companies, IT firms, everyone is really looking for this. So this is kind of a big growing field. And so for students who are very IT minded and also analytical minded, it's a good combination for those students.
Okay, what is the duration of course?
Sure. So the data analytics program is 16 months. So students will do 4 semesters consecutively so that the program is a little bit accelerated to get students graduated faster.
Okay. And what are the career opportunities once the students finish this data analytics program?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Sure. So we've had students go on to roles like consulting, various roles within IT, and various types of roles as analysts for various companies. And we see this also in companies that are small, medium, and large size, and within Minnesota, but also throughout the United States as well.
And this data analytics, is it a STEM-based program?
It is. It is a STEM-based program. So the nice thing about STEM-based programs is that when students complete the program, they're eligible for 12 months of optional practical training, or OPT, which allows students to work full-time for 1 year in their field of study. And for students in STEM-based programs, they actually can extend OPT for 2 extra years to get 3 years total. So students in the data analytics program will actually get 3 years of OPT. So they'll get the first year, and then they extend for 2 more years into that STEM extension.
Okay, what are all the services available for Indian students especially?
Sure. Yeah. So at Concordia, we have a variety of student support services so that when you arrive to our campus, you are not alone. There are always people there to help you. So one of the big services we have available on our campus is our library services. So there are librarians there 24/7 to help students. So if you are working on homework or assignments late at night and you need help with your research, or you have some other question related to that, you can always get in touch with a librarian to help you. And our library services also offer tutoring support and writing support. And the nice thing about especially the writing support is that's also available online and available 24/7 to students. So again, no matter when you're working on your assignments or when you're working on your homework, that support is always there for you. And it's also free for you as students. You can use it as much as you need. And another big support that we have on campus is the Office of International Student Services. So our Office of International Student Services has 5 full-time staff there that work directly with the students that come on campus. So our office is always providing immigration advising and academic advising and various events and programs to the students that are studying on our campus.
Okay, so what are the students' clubs and other activities available for the students?
Sure. So we have over 30 clubs that students can join. And one of our largest and most active clubs on campus is our ISA, our Indian Student Association. And so it's a great place to meet other students and join in various events and activities. There are also different athletics events happening on campus. So Concordia University St. Paul is a Division II athletics. And so any student from Concordia can go and watch those games for free and really kind of enjoy the athletics. So if you like to watch volleyball or American football or basketball, you have the opportunity to do that for free as a student. If you are someone who really likes to play sports, we also have what's called intramural sports, and it's kind of like club sports. So it's where students can join and play sports for fun, but the students have a lot of kind of competition with it. They even compete for trophies. So it's a really fun way to meet people and get involved on the campus.
Okay, so what are the all programs that Concordia University is offering to the students for spring intake?
Sure. So in the spring intake, students can start in the MS in data analytics and also the MS in information technology management. And in the spring intake, students can also start for undergraduate programs. So if students are interested in undergraduate programs like business, international business, psychology, computer science, those are all programs that can start in the spring as well.
Okay, so one more point students and the parents consider is the weather conditions available there. So how is the weather conditions over there?
Sure, that's a great question. So Minnesota is located in the center of the US, up north, and we border Canada on the north side. So the kind of weather conditions you experience in Minnesota is all four seasons. So students studying in Minnesota will experience spring, summer, fall, and winter. So it's kind of a fun experience because our summers are nice and hot, and you'll see people outside enjoying at the rivers and lakes and parks and really just spending time outside together. And then in the fall, you can see everywhere in Minnesota the beautiful leaves as the trees are changing colors. And so a lot of students enjoy traveling around in the fall to take pictures of the scenery because it's so nice and so beautiful to see the oranges and the reds and the yellows. And then in the winter, we have a true winter with snow. And so students can take the opportunity to learn snow skiing, ice skating, try sledding. And then in the next spring, students will also have an opportunity to experience that with the snow melting and the trees getting green again and the flowers coming up and just sort of welcoming in summer. So it's a fun way to experience all four seasons while you study.
Okay, if parents want to visit their students or children, so how the family visiting is planned there?
Sure. So families are always welcome to visit while their students are studying in Minnesota. If you have an undergraduate student, their required semesters are fall and spring, but we do have a winter break at the end of December for 2 weeks. And then summertime is also a break for undergraduate students. So the summertime can be a really great time to visit, especially because the weather is so nice in Minnesota in the summertime. If your student is a graduate student, there are 2 week breaks in between the semesters. So it can be nice to visit your student during those breaks in between the semesters and have a chance to see more of Minnesota or even travel around the US together.
That's great. And how the medical services are planned for the students?
Sure.
Whenever there is an emergency.
Sure. That's a great question. So at Concordia University St. Paul, we provide an international student health insurance plan for all of our students because we want to make sure they have good coverage while they study with us at Concordia. And so all students that are studying with us are automatically enrolled in that plan. And the charges for that plan just appear on the student account just like tuition does. So we make it easy for the students to pay it as well. And that insurance coverage will cover students the whole time they are studying with us up until they start their OPT. Once they graduate and are on OPT, then they can pick their own health insurance plan or get their health insurance from their employer at that time.
Okay, tell us about the campus security aspects.
Sure. Yeah. Sure. So at Concordia, we have a security office that is open 24/7. So they provide a variety of services. There are always security guards that are monitoring and walking around the campus. Every building has security guards in it to check and make sure that the grounds are safe, that the activities on campus are safe. There are also patrol cars where they drive around the campus to check and make sure that everything is safe. And they also provide a 24/7 escort service. So if you are on campus and need to go to another building or another area of campus, maybe your class finishes in the evening and you need to walk to your car, you can use the escort service for free to have somebody walk with you so that you can ensure your safety while you're on campus.
Okay, thank you so much, Tiffany, for being here, and thanks for the valuable inputs. Thank you.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. So, this is the Ivalti Study Time. Keep watching TV5. Yeah.